Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Toyotatimes Athletes Now. That the Morita Kyonosuke, I'm the Nozomi, I'm Sato Keita, and then that we support 234 GTGA athletes in 47 countries and regions. And then this was the 28th day since the Olympic Games, and something new happened. In other words, directly, we delivered our support to the athletes. So the Tyrone Pirae, that we had a feature that the day before his competition, he sent his comment on Instagram. And right after this, the javelin throwing event will take place. So let's cheer him up again. Right before his event, go for it, Tyrone, for Yaris. So, 2 more days to go at this timing. We got the supporting message.
Hi, I'm Jari-Matti Latvala, team principal of Toyota Gazoo Racing World Rally Team. And I want to give you my personal message to all the athletes in Japan for Paralympic Games. Toyota is supporting the games, and also together with the personal support from Akio Toyota. This kind of support is really important. It makes you feel like home. And on the other hand, it also gives you the best chances to do your best results in the sport you are competing. And when you do results, you need that sisu for that. That's a Finnish thing, what we call it, the guts, the never giving up attitude. When you want to do wins or you want to take the medals, you need this kind of attitude that you have to do practice all over again and again and again until you are satisfied with your performance. And with that kind of work, with this, together with the sisu, you can take the medals home. So go fight and do your best.
So race is the word that he's in. And because of that, he has given us a message with such a significance. Thank you. So after the Paralympic Games next weekend, the WRC, the event in Greece in October, games in his home country, Finland. So we cheer for you at the SUSI, the Tempia. Well, everyone, 2 more days to go. Please support till the end. Toyotatimes live. So hashtag, please. And then please post your message on our SNS. 2 more days only. So let's keep cheering up. YouTube and Instagram, even during the show, please, we are waiting for your comments to our chat. So this broadcasting is translated into English as well. So for like Tyrone-san, foreign GTGAs can join anytime. After the broadcasting, the archives are there for you. Just 2 more days. If you miss it, please turn to our archives. The Olympics and Paralympics archives are available. So before the last day, please reflect upon that special feature today. You are not alone. Together with the development team, be the best in the world. Tomorrow is the last day where the marathon takes place. Suzuki Tomoki is here. He has the dependable the friends and colleagues. How the Toyota team has prepared the equipment for him to its perfection. And then I think these people are really for the perfection. At the relay that he got the medal, and then he has the momentum. We look forward to his good performance tomorrow. So please stay with us till the end. Now, our result for yesterday and today, GTTA and their performance and results, GTTA. And then the red colors are shown here. First, this para-athletics yesterday, Sato-san mentioned universal relay result. The UK Peacock, the silver medal, Suzuki of Japan, the bronze medal. Congratulations. Really, that all those 4 runners? At a different class, they were running all together in a way. So GTTA members got the medals. And then today, the athletics, the Valencia from Colombia, the men's shot put F-34, he won. And then the Warriors in the USA men's 200 T-64 qualifying, he was a third qualified, and then the final is tonight. And men's long jump T-20, Malaysia's Abdulaziz Romli is currently competing right now. And the wheelchair basketball men's semifinal, the Steve Serio USA defeated Spain and they are to the final. And on the last final game is against Japan. Para swimming men's 200 meter freestyle S3. The freestyle, the Mexican the Lopez Diaz is the backstroke under the swimmer and he got a silver medal. Congratulations, Lopez Diaz. He got all three medals. The bronze, silver, and gold, he'll bring it back to home. Now, para taekwondo, men's K44 75 kilogram class, Mexico, the Juan Diego Garcia. Congratulations for gold medal. A new the event, para taekwondo. He's the first champion of that history. Next, para badminton. Today, Fujihara in the singles SL3 class, semifinal, he was defeated by India. But in the bronze medal match, he had a competition against the other Indian player. A mixed doubles SL3 SU5 semifinal, he lost against France. So he will go to this bronze medal match tomorrow. And then the foot five aside, the Ricardo Alves is competing against Argentina, world number one rank. That the fifth consecutive victory is up to that. Right now it's going on. So I have reported to you the result of the Toyota athletes so far.
Now, let's move on to the today's special. You are not alone. Together with the development team, be the best in the world. So this is the second series of You Are Not Alone and following the Guide Runner program. This time, we focus on him. Suzuki Tomoki, he is on a wheelchair to be engaged in marathon in T54 when he was 8 months old. He injured his spinal cord and he started para athletics when he was in elementary school. He finished the first in 2020 Tokyo Marathon, and this time in his first Paralympic Games in Tokyo, in addition to 1500 meters and 800 meters, he also ran as an anchor in Universal Relay and received the bronze medal, and he will be again racing in the marathon on the last day. Seto-san, you're also engaged in athletics, and therefore there must be interaction exchange with him.
Yes, I met with him at the stadium many times, and I consult with coaches all the time. I realized that Suzuki is training alone. And also, we share the same taste, that is extremely hot food. We ask him about what is interesting about the wheelchair athletics. And he said as follows, it's about the speed. Like Tour de France, or in the case of the marathon, the speed is about 30 kilometers per hour, and in the downhill, it could be more than 80 kilometers. So speed, and then there are different tactics, like drafting in case of air resistance, and trying to follow the other runners and create a queue. And the question is, how out of such a peloton, a group of athletes, how we are trying to get out of them, and that also depends on the position, different tactics will be chosen. In the case of marathon, the positioning in the course, out in, out, or different, the way to compete. And those are the aspects that you can focus on. Being on a wheelchair, you might think that we are not using our legs at all, but actually we are using a whole body in moving a wheelchair. Therefore, as such technique, that's another area that you can find enjoyable. It was very informative. There are a lot, yes, tactics. Because marathon, that is 42 kilometers, so there are various tactics that will be involved. You have to be clever, intelligent. What strikes me is that the speed is more than 80 kilometers per hour. Yeah, they are gliding just above the surface of the road. So it is as fast as a car, and on average that's 30 kilometers per hour. In the case of marathon, the world record is 2 hours, 1 minute, and 39 seconds. In the case of the wheelchair marathon, that is 1 hour, 20 minutes, and 14 seconds, 40 minutes faster. Amazing. The race starts at 6:30 tomorrow morning. So in the case of the marathon, you might think that you can start watching after 2 hours since the start, but actually it could be finished within that. So make sure that you will be there within the time that they would finish the race. And here is the film showing how he is training. So this is exactly what Sato-san stated. He is running alone. Yeah, sometimes I see that. Or all of a sudden, he slows down or speeds up. I think that was effective as an anchor in the relay. Yeah, just turn on the switch and the rush to accelerate. We just received a message from Toyota-san. Well, in the case of a car, the 80 kilometers for athlete and the wheelchair, that is comparable to about 200 kilometers on a car, because think of that, your whole body is exposed. That's why you have to wear a helmet. Suzuki-san uses the wheelchair for the athletics, and the way he drives it, at the wheel there is what is called the rim, the ring, what is shown in green. You don't hold it, but rather you hit it hard with your glove. That's how you can move forward, and depending on the athletes, the gloves could be different. In the case of Suzuki-san, the palm side is made of rubber. You know, the wheels are turning at the high speed, and therefore you have to hit it hard every time and have to continue it for 42 kilometers. Therefore, the gloves, they have to be durable. When I went to see the matches of the para athletics, when he was running toward the goal, I heard the sound that he was making by hitting the wheel with the glove. That was so resounding. So it is not the holding a ring and turning it, but rather you hit it to turn it and move forward. And there is a motivation for Suzuki to join Toyota. Yes, he wanted to join Toyota to be engaged in development of wheelchair for competition. So think of that motivation. That was his starting point. That is the reason why today's special program says you are not alone. In other words, development of his wheelchair is supported by his peers and friends. Here is a development team in Toyota. Aerodynamics and gloves, the areas that would contribute to improve the competitiveness, is what they are engaged in to support him. Of course, they are members of Toyota, and therefore they are specialists of developing cars, vehicles. So I would think that they are also good at the wheelchair development. You might think that way, that's wrong, because there is a major difference between the cars and wheelchairs in terms of the people that are involved. Because in the case of car, it is an engine that would drive a car, but in the case of the wheelchair, the person, the human, that is the source of the driving. And also, in the case of the drivers on the car, they would turn the steering wheel and stepping on the gas, but such a motion is not that fast. But in the case of the wheelchair, they have just seen that he is moving very fast, and therefore we'll listen to Yamamoto-san, who is engaged in engineering within the team. In fact, in the case of athletes, the motion of hands are so fast, so that we gathered high-speed camera within the organization to take images with a camera that can take photos width and frames per second to analyze images, trying to find out the speed of the motion and the difference in the motion and actions. Well, we know that they are driving or they're advancing the wheelchair with arms, but they realize that there are a lot behind that. And that's how the gear development started. And here are the points that we'd like to focus on. Gloves, posture when running, positioning during the race. So let's talk about gloves that was shown in the illustration earlier. From engineering point of view, we'll listen to Hamaguchi-san about what kind of images they analyze with a high-speed camera. Yes, the use of arms. When the glove turns or rotate the wheel, there is a rim, and how the glove gets in contact with the rim. That made a big difference. When the wrist is turning, then sometimes wrists are twisted, and therefore, because of the twisting, and then there will be the excessive load on the elbow. And because of that, the arms cannot be stretched enough so that the force cannot be conducted effectively. Especially the contact of the gloves, which part of the glove stays on the rim until the very end in turning the wheel. So that kind of finding was most important in our project.
So the 1 hour and 20 minutes that the arms moved during the marathon. So how you can have an efficient movement of the arm without tiring your arms? So, and the movement of the racer should be conveyed to the wheels. Actually, that they actually drive the wheels many, many times. Sometimes that you catch the rim well, or sometimes not well. So to increase probability of good driving, to surely transmit the power to the wheels, a point contact might reduce the probability. So the surface place, the plane tactile sense was the focus of the glove improvement. So that it could be analogy that the home run or the strikeout type hitter might be changed into a good average hitter with many hits. Yeah, right analogy. Yes, you have to increase this hitting rate, 42.1 kilometer, that that hitting rate might change the time. So that's one area of improvement. So that try to increase the glove contact time with the rim just a little bit, and then it could impact the speed and fatigue in the long run. Next point is posture during the race. So the development team recognized the unique features of the wheelchairs. What is it? Air resistance. Right. Yes. Well, for the car development, the vehicle, the air resistance has to be reduced, so the body shape is designed that way. But in case of wheelchairs, the when the size of the person is compared to the chair size, the rider's body consists of the big portion, so that against the air resistance during the ride, maybe posture can be improved. And there could be some improvement made by changing the posture. So this is direct contact, that's a less one, and then the minimizing the air resistance. So within the team, the aerodynamic the supporter and researcher is the Murayama-san. So he made a comment, and he told us the idea which first occurred to him. The first idea came to me that Tokyo Marathon was held in 2018. Right after the start in Shinjuku, there was a downward slope. And he was riding in parallel with the other and without a difference, but the other one passed him easily. At the moment, Suzuki's upper body was raised, which may have made a difference. So if the body is closely attached to the racer chair, maybe the air, the resistance could be lowered. That was one point of finding for me. So during the actual race that they came to this recognition. So what did they do? So during this ride, what kind of airflow is surrounding him. So they investigated this by using the wind tunnel test. So this is a view of that test. Please look at this one. You might have seen this. Like an automobile shape is usually used, but you put the wind and then you visualize what's happening even under the seat. The airflow is being monitored. This is from the rear. Actually, the air goes through the wheelchair and the person, and the airflow is observed. Suzuki himself entered this wind tunnel room and then participated in the measurement test. The key point is that the quantification to show those numbers to Suzuki. For example, if the back angle is raised by 20 degrees, air resistance increased by 20%. In addition to air resistance, in many areas, data should be indicated. And then athletes and development teams members understand each other in order to improve together. So what do you think of this, Sato-san? This is a difficult challenge, I felt, because they show me data, and this is much better based upon the data finding. But even though they give me data, which may be different from my own sensitivity or my sense, so data clearly indicates this. But for us, a human person, I have my own sense. So sometimes it's difficult to reconcile between those two views, my own sense versus data, which recommends that I should do this. It's very difficult to have that alignment or reconciliation. So when there are data numbers, how do you make use of those data? The data tells me this, and if I'm told that, sometimes I reject it sometimes because I like to depend on my own sense. But my own sense and some of the changes I should make if the improvement is made. And finally, the data might show this improvement change. And that good data will give me confidence. But during the race, you are not just riding all by yourself. There are other the athletes in front of you and by your side and in your back. So air resistance might be different depending upon who's around you. Nagasaki-san, a good question indeed. That's right. As she said exactly, where are you positioned? Because in the wind tunnel test, you are alone. But if the other riders are around, because the air resistance might be different. So what did they measure then? The third point today, that is the position taking during the ride, the race. Please take a look. During the Rio, the wheelchair marathon, the riders are mixed, going back and forth. So a little behind the other rider may seem less tiring, but it's a very hard competition. So you might hit because a person, your front wheel might hit the rear wheel of the forerunner. So to what extent you should be away from the forerunner, and then how close you should be. So we wanted to really quantify that. So they think up to these details. So it's the automobile company. Wow, Toyota has a strength there. Nagasaki-san, in softball batting, it may be interesting to research that maybe optimum rotation given to the ball by the type of a swing to enable long distance hit. Oh, baseball I like. You like it too? Maybe Morita-san is a great fan of baseball, more than I. But anyway, Sato-san, that in sprint, that you're athletic. But what do you think of this air resistance? Yes, in air resistance, in the sprint, only 10 some seconds we run. So we might not think to that level. So running fast, your posture and so on might be more important. So it's different from the maybe wheel, chair, the athletics of the race. So you might be surprised to see this in-depth consideration and experiments. So based upon the test results, what is the finding, the optimal positioning? Terada-san, in charge of aerodynamics, is responding to that question. position taking, yes, the distance should be the optimal, like 50 centimeter, that you don't hit the rider in front. Then air resistance will not be that different, because it's almost the same low level as you are right behind the other the rider. So you don't have to force yourself to be too close to the rider in front of you. Though you are right behind, you still have to look closely at the road condition in front. And you might move sideways to look at the road ahead. But about 20 centimeter sideways movement is still okay. The impact is still small. So those are the findings that we learned from the wind tunnel test. So what Terada-san mentioned, that there are certain things you have to think to reduce the air resistance. And safety is another importance. So this is a summary of verification. First, as to this, the interval between the first rider and the one behind, 50 centimeter, and the and 3 meters away, and so on, 50 centimeter away, the resistance wasn't that much different. Then, this one, to make the vision clear in front of you, how far can you be? 0 and then 20 and 60 centimeters, and those that were compared. Even though you move sideways by 20 centimeters, air resistance wasn't that different. In other words, you don't hit the rider in front, and then you can see well, and air resistance can minimize. So the answer is the position 50 centimeters behind the front runner and 20 centimeters away to the side. That might be optimal state. So that's the approach. What do you think of this, Sato-san? Maybe other athletes haven't really tested to that extent. But anyhow, maybe we have the gut feeling that the resistance might be minimized with that distance or interval. So we have that the gut feelings that we accumulated over the years. But anyway, Suzuki-san now is backed by all that hard data, optimal distance and interval, to minimize the air resistance. So during the race, that should be giving him a strength. Nagasaki-san, what do you think of this in-depth research? I'm amazed, impressed. We didn't really know that details. And the wheelchair, the athletes didn't know this as well. This is a sort of a crucial information. It was never released in the internet. I'm wondering if this variable, the data, could be mentioned here or not. But anyway, for the each competition, this is the company which developed and do R&D of vehicles. That's why the hard data was obtained. Suzuki-san, when you go sideways a little bit, and you used to worry about the resistance, but now he can really feel secure to look at the front and then still minimize the air resistance. So they had a good collaboration with the development team. So Suzuki-san mentioned about this. I didn't think that the wind was blowing so hard. So during the race, the concentration is very high, and then he wouldn't recognize the airflow. But through these wind tunnel tests, he has experienced the actual wind flows. So for him and for me as well, it was a wonderful findings that we came up with. So that kind of feel was experienced by Suzuki. That was a great experience for him. Exactly. Maybe the athletes might not recognize during the race. That's true. So, but these data finding let him recognize this. Toyota friends helped to give that finding. You need R&D for that, which will improve the level of this competition as well. Suzuki-san and his support R&D team work together. This story is so moving. And this could be called the only one story, the wonderful story, as the CEO the Toyota mentioned. So the improvement increased top speed by 1 to 2 kilometers, but in the world of 30 kilometers per hour, 1 to 2 kilometers improvement mean a lot. Tomorrow at the 6:30, the marathon competition will start within 12 hours from now. I'm sure that the athletes already went to bed by now. And the development team members now are getting excited and nervous. Looking forward to the competition tomorrow, the marathon T54, the wheelchair class. The competition starts at 6:30. Within 1 and 20 minutes, that the game is over. But let's look forward to his gold medal to be world number one. So you are not alone. Together with the development team, be the best in the world.
Now, before ending the program, I'd like to share with you the schedule of GTTAs. And this is the last day that we will introduce the schedule of various events for tomorrow. First, Pele of South Africa, F63. It was exactly about the same time yesterday. Do you remember that he was also joining the program through SNS? But he was in the training in the gym. And right now, he is in the new national stadium, aiming for full Yaris. I think his race is about to start, and therefore, Tyrone, go for it. He's in the men's shot put. Men's 200 meter T64, Jared Wallace. This is going to be the last race for him. And this is going to be the third Paralympic Games, and he's aiming for the first medal. He is a close friend of yours. Yes. I'd like to send a supportive message, the message of support wholeheartedly. I'm sure that message was delivered to you. And then about the marathon, the race would be finished in about 1 hour and 20 minutes. The Suzuki Tomoki and the Patrick Monathan, they will be competing. They were in T54, and also Mitsushita-san will be competing as well. She was introduced during the guide runner program. She is in T12, and she is also racing in the women's marathon and the para badminton. Fujihara is going to compete, aiming for the bronze medal match, the first the new event that was selected this time. He's from SL3 and wheelchair basketball. The USA of Serial. The Serial USA, they are going to face Japan over gold medal. And please, the check for the results and the Toyotatimes athletes now. There is a special site. I realized that I mentioned about Tyrone on the Instagram yesterday, right before the program. And then that resulted in such a exciting program. So you are the reason behind that. Yes. I was there. So please send your message of support with the hashtag Toyotatimes Live. You never know what happens. That's we started the program at 7 p.m. and the 12th program is about to finish. And we received messages from two Croatian athletes, GTTAs. The Vincetic of Croatia and Moreno of Argentine.
Hello to everybody, my name is Christian and I'm a proud member of Delta family for more than 2 years. Greetings from the Paralympic Village in Tokyo. Bye.
I am Lance Moreno, an Argentine adapted tennis player, and I would like to thank Toyota for their support during this last time. Because it was a great help to qualify and participate in the Tokyo 2020 Paralympics Games. Yeah, we are so happy to hear the return messages from athletes that we supported. We received a lot of comments today, right? Who would start off? I would. Yoichiro Maeda. I didn't know that in a wheelchair, the runners are hitting the wheels. Yes, frankly speaking, I came to know that for the first time. I thought that they were also holding the wheel to turn it. But after hearing the explanation, yeah, that makes sense. Yuri-san, aerodynamics and resistance. And what Saito-san stated just sounded like the racer. Yes. Maybe another aspect of affinity with the motorsport. Comment on YouTube. Koizumi-san says,
The team that is so eager for research and development is there to support him. Yes, he is not alone. Dobashi-san, across national borders and across different events and disciplines, whether it is Olympic Games or Paralympic Games, this is the way the sport should be because you have been covering those games. Yes, that's a very good way to summarize what we have been doing so far. Tomorrow, this is going to be the last day of the Paralympic Games. So we'd like to look back to Tokyo 2020 Paralympic Games and look at the stories of each individual athletes, the stories unique to each individual athletes, and then let's make it a time to think more about Paralympic Games. And therefore, tomorrow, Nagasaki-san and Kozuka Yaris Takahiko will join us, and online, Ashida-san, Saito-san will be there too. And because this is the last program, I know the father of a family would be there as well. And the messages by our friends from sites of Toyota organization, well, you can only see those messages for the last two times. So are the Naoto Inti Limes Tokyo Summer. But let's be cheerful. I am Morita Kyonosuke, Sato Keita, and Nagasaki Nozomi. So see you tomorrow once again at 7 o'clock, when Toyota.
Loneliness in my heart.